Welcome to another of my Thursday video diary updates. This is the third week in a three-week house sitting block, so I think if you look around the building, there'll be lots of tired and harried MPs and staff wandering around the building. It's been another big week here in Parliament, and I spoke yesterday in the general debate, and although there were lots of things that opposition parties have been focusing on, including things like man bans, I actually chose to focus on what the government's doing around achieving our better public service targets. And we've got fantastic news in terms of making progress in the 10 areas of public service targets that we've set. Some of those targets include things like increasing the number of children in early childhood education. That's increasing. Increasing the number of 17-year-olds who have NCEA level 2 or higher. Also targets an NCEA level 4, which is the 25 plus age bracket. We're also seeing improvements in other areas that we're measuring, such as crime. And you may have recalled me saying here previously that we have crime levels now that have dropped to a 30-year low. And that's from a whole raft of measures that this government's put in place. I've also talked a lot about our vulnerable children work. And so it's really great to see that the number of reported incidents against children is dropping. So I think that the better public service targets are really working. What it does is focuses people's attention on what really matters. And it's been interesting reading the surveys that you've been sending back to me. Your comments are very much reflecting the areas we're working on. Increasing educational achievement levels, lowering crime so that our streets and community are safer, growing jobs and growing the economy. So I think we're right in the space that you want us to be, and so I talked about that in the general debate. Next week's going to be really exciting here in Parliament. For Tuesday and Wednesday, it's the Youth Parliament. So the Youth MP for Taupo, Stella Ivory, will be representing the Taupo electorate. She's been doing a fantastic job of gathering young people's views from across the electorate. So she'll be here next week speaking on behalf of the young people in the Taupo electorate, and I'm hoping I'll be able to bring you a special edition of that next week. The other thing that's probably, I'm hoping, fingers crossed, that we managed to get completed today in the House is the Psychoactive Substances Bill. That of course is the bill that will significantly change the landscape for legal highs. It's another thing I get lots of comments on, lots of feedback in my surveys, is that you don't want these legal highs, you don't want them in the community. Tūrangi's already stopped selling them, now Putaruru has as well. In Tokoroa today, I understand that there's another processed outside the shop that's selling it. Well, I want to assure you this government is taking our work seriously to reduce the harm from these legal bans. And actually, after this bill passes, it will be incredibly difficult for those products to pass the tests to say that they don't cause harm to people who use them. So stand by, we are, as a government, doing the things that you want us to be focusing on. Thanks, and I'll catch up with you next week.